Marilyn Monroe's third marriage to playwright Arthur Miller hit the rocks when it is thought she found Mr. Miller's scrawlings, where he called her a W.E. A documentary based on tape recordings of conversations between journalist and author, Anthony Summers, and those closest to the actress has given new insight into the tragic life of Hollywood's golden girl. Mr. Summers began investigating her life in 1982, after he was commissioned by the Daily Express magazine, following the case into her death being reopened 20 years after the fateful night in August 1962. Marilyn Monroe's secret night in a hotel room with Elvis started kissing immediately. Marilyn Monroe slept with some of the most famous men in the world, and even married two of them. But the Hollywood star also spent one secret night of passion with Elvis, according to a sensational memoir. Express.co.uk reveals how the girl known as Norma Jean spent one evening with the King of Rock and Roll. The Pulitzer Prize nominee conducted multiple interviews with those who knew Marilyn and were closest to the Some Like It Hot star. Speaking on the documentary, Mr. Summers told of the moment Marilyn was heartbroken after finding Mr. Miller's notes about his wife. He said, after a party, she happened upon some notes that Mr. Miller had left lying around. Marilyn told her acting coach it was something about how disappointed he was in me. How he thought I was some kind of angel, but now he guessed he was wrong. He'd married a woman as flawed as his previous wife had been. Miller also wrote in the note that she was a W.E. Mr. Summers went on to say that it was an incident Marilyn would refer to often, with it appearing to mark the beginning of her decline. Her hairdresser Sidney Gilleroff, who knew Marilyn throughout her career, told how she was not happy during many times of her life. Billy Wilder notoriously had problems with Marilyn on set of the hit film, Some Like It Hot, as she would request to redo scenes multiple times during filming in 1958. The director of many classic Hollywood films also spoke to Mr. Summers. However, Mr. Wilder perceptively told the now 79-year-old Mr. Summers that he did not have a problem with Marilyn, instead she had a problem with herself. He said, she was slightly discombobulated at all times, but by God, when you suffered through that scene, through the 30, 40, 50 takes sometimes, I had no problems with Monroe. Monroe had problems with Monroe. She had problems with herself. Yet, John Huston, who directed Marilyn in both The Asphalt Jungle and The Misfits, said it was while working on the latter that he saw her decline and reliance on drugs. He told Mr. Summers how occasionally on set, Marilyn would be practically unable to understand what was going on around her, as if in a daze. Mr. Huston told Mr. Summers, I was aware from the beginning of her decline. She was not the fresh little girl that I had known originally. Very soon we were aware that she was a problem. She'd be late on the set always. Sometimes the whole morning would go by, sometimes she'd be all right. Occasionally, she'd be practically non-compos mentis. The narcotics were the problem. I discovered this in the course of the picture, The Misfits. I remember saying to Mr. Miller one day, I said, you know that if she went on at the rate that she was going, why, she'd be in an institution in 2 or 3 years, or dead. And I said, anyone who allows her to take a drug ought to be shot. Marilyn was abusing prescription drugs, as those in Hollywood often do, according to Mr. Summers. He told how Marilyn used uppers, namely amphetamines, for years, as well as sleeping pills, the very drugs she took before she died. Tragically, she died aged just 36, the year after The Misfits was released in 1962, due to a probable suicide following an overdose. The documentary, directed by Emma Cooper, is based on Mr. Summers' book, Goddess. The Mystery of Marilyn Monroe, The Unheard Tapes is available on Netflix.